and welcome to Queen Coral Plays Zombie Cafe for Furori Gaming. Do forgive me, I literally filmed this months ago. Didn't know where I put it on my computer. I found it, so now I can actually do the voiceover to it. So, yeah, this is the second part. I did one a while ago. It's actually got quite a lot of views, to be fair. I think it was like 70 yards. So hopefully all you guys are watching again. So hi. If not, if it's the first time, check out part one if you haven't. But yeah. At the moment, it seems like I've got a bit of a thing going. I've got my food out, you know. Got the two zombies lying on the floor. I've clearly done an attack on another. Okay, there's a guy in a nappy. clearly done an attack on another cafe, and they're regenerating. The regeneration takes hours. That's part of what I don't really like about this game. The fact that there is a lot of waiting, like 45 minutes. That's like one of the lowest times you'll get for the food. There is another cooker you can get, which half the time, I believe. But that would still make things about an hour and a half, and it's just not what you want to do on such a slow-paced game. You want fast-paced things. Yeah, so you've got them goals. So that's not too bad. But we've got 464 of one plate, 159 of the other, and 98 of another. So we're going really, like, we're going strong, and that's like the strongest I've had for food in a long time. I must have let it run before I started playing this, because stuff like that take a long time, and I don't really have the patience. Whereas there's a lot to do on other games, there isn't much you can actually do on here. There's no growing food or anything. It's literally plant your food, and that's it really. Not plant it, like cook your food. I don't know why I'm looking at that. I never actually buy that, I believe. I think I'm just looking at things. And there's a lot you need to do, like with toxins as well. It takes a while to get them up. Yeah, you can get them by watching ads, which is a good thing to do when you're watching TV. Just sit it on the side and redo it every now and then. But it does become a pain in the bum. So we've got the Zombiepedia, and these are all the zombies we can collect. And have them, but obviously they don't unlock until we get to certain levels. These are the kind of ones we can unlock. They're the ones I have unlocked, but I haven't really got many of them, because I'm kind of sticking to my own ones. They're leveling up, so I'm sure as I progress through the levels, if I do, I can get more and just play around with it then. But I must be honest, I am getting a little bit bored of this game. I have played it since filming this, just a little bit, and it's a lot of just doing food. And that there's not much you can do. You attack a calf, and then you come back, and you need them all to regenerate again. It's not the best. Part of me wants to keep it because I like the theme. I'm very into the theme, and I like these games. But it's become a bit like, oh, is that it kind of thing. I think I've done as much as I can with it. You know what I mean? But I'm seeing how it's going. I'll keep it around for a little bit longer. But whether anything plays out good or whatever, I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. So I think I'm looking at the cookers at the moment. Like I said, there is some that make it cook a little bit more. There's like percentage faster or 50% faster, something like that. Something that goes on, and I'm just a bit fed up. It takes a while, so I'm hoping if I get another counter, that I start to actually have like more I could put out. So while I am cooking, because the problem is we don't have enough cash, you see what I mean? You can't do much. So it costs money to get toxins. Half the items you need to get cost toxins, so you pretty much, no idea what that game is, so you pretty much have to watch the ads to get the toxins. I wouldn't do it while I was filming, because you have to watch things. We've got zomblets. Another problem that I don't like, you can't cook the food and then put it in the fridge. There is a way that you cook for friends, but I don't understand how to do it, and I haven't got any friends on it, so that might be why. Although I'm pretty sure, I can't remember that if it's right, but I think Jordan downloaded it. And I tried to give him my code, and I show the code in this, I know that. But that disappeared once she got it, so I don't know if that's a... might still a thing, because there was an update. I know I said that it hadn't been updated in a long time, but it actually has, because it's updated for Halloween and everything as well. So Not too sure what's going on there. But there's my calf, we're level 8. There you go, you see up there it says invite friends. Oh yeah, and I found out that you can find random players' cafes. So this kind of helped me with ideas. But clearly these guys are leveled up a lot more. Look, they got their pets. I couldn't figure out how to get. I figured out how to get them, but I haven't got the money or the toxins. Right, like I'm watching it. Like they look quite cool, but this one looks quite bare. But it kind of gives you ideas. You can just go through. This is another one. I mean, they're level 17, so they're about 9 levels ahead of me. And as you can see, it hasn't progressed much. You tell me, I've got a long way to go just to actually do anything. And I think without actually paying money to play the game, it's not that worth it. So I'm really on the fence at the moment, guys. Like, if you comment below, let me know if you're any further ahead or any kind of things you've given yourself to actually go further with it. There isn't much online, to be honest, that I can find out. But it'd be nice to have some, like, in-game goals or something that I could do just to make it carry on a bit longer. Because at the moment, I find myself cooking, turning it off, going to another game, coming back in an hour. And it's a bit pointless. It's a bit of a waste of time, really. I might as well get another game that does a similar thing. Now, I quite like the way this has gone out. Because when I was looking for this, like, this is level 54. It's still not really much different to mine. But at the time, I was trying to figure out how I could put more tables in. Because I was struggling with how much room I got, because people weren't able to get to tables or chairs, things like that. They weren't able to serve them food. They could sit down, but then they couldn't get the food to them. So obviously, this is one little way of doing it. I'm pretty sure the people inside are trapped. I can't really see a way out, unless they can actually walk through the tables. I know it gets glitchy and they walk through the tables, but I'm not sure if they can. I quite like this one. This one's only 16, so they've done quite a lot of it. But I guarantee they've sat there for a long time watching the adverts, and the adverts sometimes say, "Oh, you've watched too many. We haven't got any more. Come back soon." You could have a good few days about being able to get one. And you see what I mean? There's a referral code. If you got it, add that code. Add me. You know. I'm assuming that's how that works. There's nothing on my leaderboard, so I don't. Couldn't tell you. But what was I saying? It'd be nice to have someone to play with, but like, I was trying to figure out how to move things and so they wouldn't get trapped. But clearly there's a lot more zombies than what I've got. It took me a while to figure out how to use the storage as well. I think this is when. I'm not too sure. But I mean, these are the little things you got, but they're like the one I've got now after this one. I've got to make meals that take like 3 hours. I don't have that time in my life to sit there and wait for that to do. And if I put it down, I forget. And it's just kind of, it's not what I want. So when I do go on there, I make the 1 5-minute meal we have and then turn it off just to get the money generated. So if you've got any kind of tips and tricks, I'm up for it. See what I can do, but I don't know if I'll do any more of this game. Just because there's nothing to progress from, nothing really much to see. Unless I have a major progression, I probably won't do another part until then. But it's always good to try out, but I may possibly delete it and start something new. I've run out, I've got a lot of games, and I have run out of memory on my iPad. And I can't remember how much memory my iPad is, but it's not the lowest one. So as you can probably tell, I play a lot of games. Maybe if I do stop playing, I will delete it. There's ones I like to go back to for a little while. I give up and then go back to a few months later. But this is me just looking through the chefs. I don't think they speed anything up. I know it's a speed, but I don't think it actually speeds anything up. But because all your other zombies can cook as well. And a lot of them cost toxins. As you can see, I've only got 6. And I'm only on level 8. It's a very slow-paced game, you see. And I hope you're enjoying the video. I'm not. But yeah, it's alright. The thing is, I enjoy games like that. And I said it when I did the Paradise Bay one earlier. I enjoy these games. But when they become slow paced, they get boring. And I do have my little system, but this one doesn't really work in the system as much because you literally set it up. And what I like about other games like Paradise Bay, Gourmet Ranch, things like that, you can leave it for a good few days and you've left things cooking. And you can come back and it's absolutely fine. You come back to this and it's spoiled. So you could put something on, because there's food on here, it takes 3 days. I'm sorry, but that's friggin' ridiculous. Right. Who has that time? But 3 days, I'm gonna forget in about half an hour that I've put something on. And I'm not gonna start setting reminders on my phone because I could be at work in 3 days' time. You know what I mean? I can't plan my life around a virtual meal. So I'm a bit like, well, that's a bit silly. So I can't use that, even though I'll probably get so many points and things like that. I'm not gonna waste my time putting a 3 day meal on. Like, who, like, in real life, you don't even take 3 days to make a meal. So it's just kind of like, that's my problem with that game. And I'm only on level 8. Like, I can't imagine what it gets to later on, like 10 days and things like that. I don't check back on this game too much. The thing is, you'll forget you would have used all your money for the food. And it's spoiled. And then just to save it, you need to use a load of toxins. So it's just kind of like, it's not worth it. I mean, it's a very clever tactic for the company. Not saying that they're like money making, but if you are really into a game, things like World of Warcraft and things like that, you pay for it because you enjoy it. And if someone enjoys this game, they would fully pay for the toxins because of what you get out of it. So I don't blame them, and I think it's a good way to draw money in from the game. I just think it would be nicer if it was easier to get some so everyone can play, because I never pay for games like this ever. I'm just saying it. Because I think if I start spending money on it, I'd never delete it, even if I played it or not. And then because things like iPads and that, you get new ones and updates all the time, things stop working. And that's when I'd get annoyed. I just couldn't cope. I wouldn't be able to cope with that. Not with my OCD. But, yeah, I mean, the good thing about it, these meals last a very long time. Like, the thing is, you can't sit here all day and wait for that. I can't make another meal because it just sits on top of it. And then gets rid of what we've already got. So there is a lot of glitches in this game, and I'm figuring it out the further I go along. Not so much glitches, it's just doesn't work out the way I think it should, kind of thing. But I suppose this is when you set in the one that takes 2 hours, but I'm not going to sit here watching this for 2 hours. It just seems a bit pointless. But yeah, very on the fence about this game at the moment. It's not much else to say really, and I've still got like 5 minutes of video. This is fun, guys. I mean, I've got quite a few games coming up. I'm gonna hopefully be doing one for Scrubby Dubby soon, which is the new King game. If I can get Looney Tunes Dash working again, because there's an update and it just won't open on my iPad now. It opens and then crashes and closes, so I can't actually get to a level. But I would like to do that because I YouTubed some of the further levels. I'm not that far into it. I'm only level 10 or something, and it gets really, really good. Like, the later levels, it's really, really amazing. So as you can see me here trying to get more tables in. I do want to get another oven or something, just so we can cook a bit more, but I don't see there's any point. Yes, I would like to do bits of all my games, but the thing is, sometimes filming it, as much as I enjoy doing it and I like giving out the content, it can sometimes put a burden on your games and you can't play it without recording it, if that makes sense. Which is what I'm having a bit at the moment with Bubble Witch. I like doing that, I like promoting it, but there's a lot of editing that I have to do it, and I feel like I can't play without doing it, because when I'm in the levels, I think I'm 70 something now, in the levels, it takes me a good, like, long time to do certain levels, and I don't want to do that twice, because Wolfgar, Jake, he suggested playing it in my own time and then going back and recording it, and I said, yeah, I thought about that, but I will have to do levels that have taken me a good hour or so to get past in the first place. So at the moment, I'm not sure if I'd want to do just the odd episode, playing a few levels, and then kind of going from there. So I can play it in my own time and then present a few levels and play it a bit, which I think is what I'm going to do with Scrubby Dubby, because I'm not that into it at the moment. It's just getting the hang of it. It looks like Candy Crush, but it's not. But and Blossom Brass, I'm a bit weird with that one. That's another new King one. And what I don't get is there's people who aren't on my friends list on there. I googled it. I was like, what is this? And it's just extra friends that are like generated. They look like real people, but I don't think they are. You can send them friend, not friend requests, lives. But I think it's just to generate more towards you. But the latest King games haven't really seemed to pick it up. Few people are playing the new Candy Crush Jelly Saga, which is hard, by the way. If anyone's played it, it's hard. This is part two of Zombie Cafe for Fury Gaming by Queen Coral. I hope you've enjoyed it and my mumbling over here, which is probably had nothing whatsoever to do with Zombie Cafe. I should probably start recording over the top when straight after I've recorded, because I have no idea what I'm doing. I can't explain myself, so therefore a bit pointless. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed it. Hope to see you soon, and I shall see you later. Bye.